Right, today we're going to talk about the watch settings on your Mantis tube. Whenever you have a watch, you're going to want to be able to set the date, the time, the country code, many features that will sometimes change often, sometimes not change very often at all, but we want you to know how to do easily adjustments on this computer. If you look at the watch settings, bottom right is going to move you into the watch mode. The cursor will be flashing at the set and you'll see watch written across the screen. If I do a light press on the select button, then I'm going to get into the alarm clock as the very first option for me to set. This is something most people will change fairly often, whether it's the weekend or during the week, as far as what they want for a wake-up time. If I press the select button, it's going to flash on. I can click plus or minus and change it to off if I want to sleep in on the weekend and not have an alarm, or I can leave it set for on. If I do another light press, then it's going to start flashing the hour. Again, I can go up and make the time go up, or I can go down with the minus button, take it down. Another nice press of the select, and it's going to allow me to change the minutes for the half hour. Again, press one more time, I've got my alarm clock set. Next, if I hit the plus button, is the country code setting. In this particular case, I'm in California for this filming, and I have it set for -8, which is the UTC code for the West Coast. This allows me to be able to know the present time, and then in just a moment, I'll walk you through setting it for a second country code setting, which is really convenient. Next, I can actually set the time itself. So if I'm not using the country code settings at all, and I just want to set the watch like you would set a regular watch with hands, then I can come in here, press the select button, the hour will flash. I can go up and down, adjust to the time, confirm, adjust the minutes, and of course make sure that if you're on 12-hour time that you have it set for AM or PM properly in order for it to work with your alarm. The next feature is the mode. You've got 24-hour mode or 12-hour mode. In the US, we generally use 12-hour mode, but people in Europe and folks that have been in the military have a tendency to prefer the 24-hour mode. If you set it for the 24-hour mode, then it's going to give you exactly what you want. In 12-hour, it's going to get you the AM, PM like we use. Next is going to be the second country code setting. For me, this is a very nice feature if you travel. And in this case, like I say, I live on the East Coast, but I'm out here in California. So I have the East Coast set for -8, and I have the back home set for -5. So my UTC code for number 2 is going to be my back home time. And when I look at the screen in the time of day mode, I have both my time at home in Tennessee, the time where I am now, and this allows me to be able to call home or whatever and not be calling too late as a quick glance. Next is the date. In this case, I have it set for August 14th of 2015. If I had it set for military time or 24-hour time, it would be the day, month, and then the year. Next, you'll see the sounds. If you can hear the sounds as I'm pushing the buttons, you'll notice that this is an audible sound that when you're diving is designed to draw your attention to the watch in case you're ascending too quickly or you're needing to make a stop or something of this nature. The sounds also allow people to know that they or have a confirmation that they are making these changes when making settings on the watch. If you would like to turn this off, you can. There's a special code that you'll find in your manual that you can program in that will allow you to disable the sounds in case you find that to be something you don't need. Next, you're going to see the battery bar graph. The battery bar graph is a really nice, fast way for you to know this battery status of your Mantis 2. Mantis 2 is designed to give you over 200 hours of diving on a single battery. So in most cases, it's going to be a couple of years before you'd ever have to change it. But if you're going on an exotic dive trip, it's always a great idea to check the battery status of any equipment you would be taking with you, and especially your dive computer that's going to be controlling your dives. So by going into the watch settings and going to the very last option in the menu, you will see some round pixels that represent the battery life status. And in another issue, we will show you actually what these battery statuses represent and how much more life you have before you need to be changing the battery.